breaking on an independent United Kingdom.
Meanwhile, we have young girls being beaten and raped, then ignored, labelled liars, and left defenceless because they're white.
On behalf of Autolycus, this is Trent Holmgren with the Europa Report for the past week, July 15th to July 22nd. Bringing you the latest news on the continent regarding new political developments and the ongoing refugee crisis. Firstly, let us begin with today, July 22nd's shocking incident in Germany, where gunmen went on a shooting rampage in a shopping mall in the southern German city of Munich, killing and wounding many people according to police reports. From mirror.co.uk, authorities were evacuating people from the Olympia Mall, but many others were hiding inside. The Bavarian Interior Ministry said three people were dead, NTV television reported. A Munich police spokeswoman said multiple people were killed or wounded. "We believe we are dealing with a shooting rampage," the spokeswoman said. More than one gunman was believed to be involved and no one had been arrested, she had said. "We believe there was more than one perpetrator." The first reports came at 6 p.m. The shooting apparently began at a McDonald's in the shopping center. "There are still people in the shopping center. We are trying to get the people out and take care of them." Police special forces had arrived on the scene, NTV said. It was not exactly clear who carried out the attack, which took place a week after an axe-wielding teenager went on a rampage on a German train. Islamic State claimed responsibility for that attack. Staff in the mall were still in hiding, an employee told Reuters by telephone. "Many shots were fired. I can't say how many, but it has been a lot," the employee, who declined to be identified, said from the mall in Munich. "All of the people from outside came streaming into the store, and I only saw one person on the ground who was so severely injured that he definitely didn't survive." Munich transport authorities said they had halted several bus, train, and tram lines. The shopping center is next to the Munich Olympic Stadium, where the Palestinian militant group Black September took 11 Israeli athletes hostage and eventually killed them during the 1972 Olympic Games. Friday's attack took place a week after a 17-year-old asylum seeker wounded passengers on a German train in an axe rampage. The non-white Afghan terrorist who attacked commuters on a train in Bavaria invaded Germany in 2015 as an unaccompanied minor claiming to be a refugee, the Bavarian Interior Minister has confirmed. From NewObserverOnline.com, the ISIS press agency Amaq has announced that he executed the operation in response to calls to target nations in the coalition fighting the Islamic State. The refugee terrorist Mohammed Riyad had been living in Würzburg since March, Die Welt newspaper reported, and after staying in refugee accommodation for several months, he had moved to live with a foster family in the nearby town of just 2 weeks ago. "That house has been searched and the foster family questioned," police said, after an ISIS flag had been found among the non-white invaders' possessions. "He was being cared for by the Catholic organization known as the Kolping Society," the Bild newspaper has revealed. Let us remind that a grand total of 2.5 million people, the vast majority of them from the Third World or Second World nations, came to Germany last year, as new figures have revealed. The extent of the deliberate displacement of Germans from Germany means that the switchover to a majority non-white nation will come even sooner than earlier predictions. According to the latest figures issued by the government's statistics agency, Destasis, last week, 2015 saw the highest levels of non-white invaders ever in German history to enter the country. During the year, a total of 2.137 million people moved to Germany, the report said, and then went on to admit that this was an underestimate. The increase in inflows to Germany in 2015 is due to increased immigration of foreign nationals. Of the total, 2.137 million migrants, 2.016 million had foreign passports, which were 674,000, or 50% more than in 2014, the official report continued. However, ordinary Germans are starting increasingly to form solid political opposition to their ethnic displacement. Specifically, the Pegida movement in Germany has announced that it is forming a political party. The People's Direct Democracy and Freedom Party, FDDV, just as the German government indicated that it was preparing to ban the anti-invasion movement. From NewObserverOnline.com, Pegida movement head Lotz Buchmann announced that the formation of the new party at a meeting in Dresden yesterday at a regular Monday evening rally in the eastern German city. According to Buchmann, the article of incorporation for the party had already been signed on June 13th and was a response to the threatened ban of Pegida. Bachman refused to announce who the founding members or provisional leader of the party would be, but pointed out that Pegida wanted to develop a parliamentary arm more than a year ago. The FDDV will not enter into direct competition with the already established Alternative for Deutschland, or AfD, party, Bachman said. In the neighboring Austria, presidential candidate Norbert Hofer has called on a crackdown of Turks who have illegal dual citizenship in Austria after mass pro-Erdogan protests by Turk in Vienna. From Breitbart.com/London, in the immediate aftermath of the failed coup attempt in Turkey last weekend, Austrian Turks took to the streets of Vienna to express their support for President Recep Tayyip Erdogan by the thousands. The protests have led to many in the Austrian political scene to question how appropriate it is for the minority in the country to be so adamantly loyal to a foreign head of state. Presidential candidate for the anti-mass migration Freedom Party, Norbert Hofer, is now calling for a government review of Turks who may possess dual citizenship with Austria and Turkey, Courier reports. Austria is unusual among European nations in that it is illegal in most cases to hold dual citizenship with another nation. Also, things are becoming ever more turbulent south of the Austrian border, where Italy's banking crisis could lead to market turmoil, and a clash between Italian Prime Minister Matteo Renzi and German Chancellor Angela Merkel. From USA.ForzaNuova.info, that amplified worries about the solvency of BMPS in the Italian banking system and heightened concerns about potential showdown between the Italian government headed by Prime Minister Matteo Renzi and the European Commission over new restrictions on government bailouts of the financial sector. As we trend into the second half of the year, the situation in Italy and its spillover for the rest of Europe will continue to be one of the biggest macro-capital political risks we are concerned about, said Federico Santi, a London-based analyst at Eurasia Group, a risk consulting group, in a note. The focus on Italy comes after the UK voted in late June to exit the European Union. In a worst-case scenario, analysts fear Italy's bank problems could threaten the country's membership in the Eurozone. In coming weeks, the situation has the potential to create at least near-term global market turmoil as financial and political risks collide. It also threatens to catch many investors who had assumed the world's banking woes were largely in check after the financial crisis by surprise. Italy's banks are neck-deep in non-performing loans. Official data puts the total amount of non-performing loans, or NPLs, at around 200 billion euros, or $220.5 billion, or around 8% of total loans. That amplified worries about the solvency of BMPS and the Italian banking system, and heightened concerns about a potential showdown between the Italian government, headed by Prime Minister Matteo Renzi, and the European Commission over new restrictions on government bailouts of the financial sector. On top of that, some 3,200 migrants were plucked from overcrowded boats off the coast of Libya on Tuesday, and one dead body was recovered, Italy's Coast Guard said, as people smugglers operating in Libya took advantage of calm seas and warm weather. A Coast Guard spokesman said the smugglers had sent at least 26 boats towards Italy and the latest tide of migrants fleeing war and poverty in Africa, the Middle East, and Asia. Three Italian Navy ships took part in rescues, picking up more than 1,000 of these brought to safety. British and Spanish ships operating within the European Union's anti-people smuggling mission also conducted rescues. Moving on to the British Isles, where new Finance Minister Philip Hammond will on Friday meet Chinese business leaders and officials to drum up support for Britain's economy ahead of talks with G20 counterparts in Chengdu. From Breitbart.com/London, former Foreign Minister Hammond will be joined by business leaders as he seeks to reassure Chinese investors and politicians that Britain is open for business despite voting last month to leave the European Union. China President Xi Jinping had said that he had hoped for Britain to remain on the bloc to promote a deepening development of China-EU ties. Hammond will visit Beijing and Hong Kong to promote British business opportunities with a strong emphasis on the financial services sector, the Treasury said. Also, Labour Party leader Jeremy Corbyn said on Thursday the result of last month's vote to leave the European Union should be respected, putting him at odds with a lawmaker who is challenging him for his job. "I think you have to respect the result of the referendum, whether you welcome it or not," Corbyn told BBC Newsnight. Corbyn, who launched his leadership campaign earlier on Tuesday, also said securing access to European markets would be a key part of any Brexit deal, but he also wanted to see some freedom of movement retained. Let us close with a brief overview of the failed coup d'etat that happened last Friday in Turkey, a country that has been, until now, poised to join the EU. It is worth mentioning that this country has been the main facilitator of non-white migration from the Middle East to Greece and the rest of Europe. From BBC.com, it all started when bridges over the Bosphorus Strait in Istanbul were blocked by troops late evening local time on Friday. Fighter jets and helicopters were seen flying over the Turkish capital Ankara and gunshots heard. Soon after, Prime Minister Binali Yildirim announced that an attempt to overthrow the government was underway. A faction of the army then said, via a state broadcaster, that it had seized power to protect democracy from President Recep Tayyip Erdogan. A curfew, martial law, and the preparation of a new constitution was announced. Mr. Erdogan, who was on holiday in a seaside resort town, called on his supporters to take to the streets in protest and return to Istanbul. Over the course of a violent night, TV stations were raided by soldiers, explosions heard in Istanbul and Ankara, protesters shot at, the parliament and presidential buildings fired upon, a military helicopter shot down, and the Turkish military chief taken hostage. For the plot to succeed, the army faction needed public support or wider military backing. Neither materialized. Opposition parties also condemned the coup. In the early hours of Saturday morning, groups of soldiers involved began to surrender. Troops abandoned their tanks with their hands up. Security forces also took back key installations and bases, including military headquarters. By Saturday evening, some of the same places that had seen such chaos the night before were filled with jubilant supporters of Mr. Erdogan. From Reuters.com, the blowback by Erdogan was severe as expected. Thousands of police officers on Monday were suspended, widening a purge of the armed forces and judiciary after a failed military coup, and raising concern among European allies that it was abandoning the rule of law. A senior security official told Reuters 8,000 police officers, including in the capital of Ankara and the biggest city, Istanbul, had been removed from their posts on suspicion of links to Friday's coup bid by a faction in the army. 30 regional governors and more than 50 high-ranking civil servants have also been dismissed, CNN Turk said. Thousands of members of the armed forces, from foot soldiers to commanders, were rounded up on Sunday, some shown in photographs stripped to their underpants and handcuffed on floors of police buses and sports halls. Several thousand prosecutors and judges have also been removed. EU Foreign Policy Chief Federica Mogherini warned the Turkish government on Monday against taking steps that would damage the constitutional order. The situation is still far from stable, and especially in a sensitive region which connects the marred by conflict and bloodshed Middle East to southeastern Europe. Well, that was all for this week, guys. For TRS Radio, this has been The Europa Report. The Europa Report is a compilation of selected articles from the following sites: NewObserverOnline.com, Breitbart.com/London, USA.ForzaNuova.info. Please support their efforts.